Welcome to Voice of the Covenant Bible Study. I'm so glad you're joining me again today. I have my Bible here. I hope you have yours. Hope you have a notebook, because I believe that God is going to show you some things personally right where you are that will transform your life. Let's open in prayer. Father, I thank you for your word, because your word is spirit and it is life. It transforms our way of thinking so that we can live as overcomers in this life. Lord, I pray for your anointing upon me as I teach, anointing on all those that are hearing and listening, Lord, so that we can experience what you want us to have for today. Lord, I thank you that you're in our midst, leading and guiding us by your spirit. Amen. You know, I hope that you've been encouraged by our theme that the Lord has given us for 2020, and it's great expectation gets great results. And we've been declaring it all year, and it is happening. But let's continue right now with the second lesson of our Bible study of this month, which is entitled, The Battle is the Lord's, but the Fight is Yours. And let's turn back in our Bible to 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 29. You know, in our last lesson, we looked at a great statement spoken by David, a teenage boy who watched over his father's sheep. You remember, his father sent David to bring food to his three brothers that were in a battle against the biggest enemy that Israel had ever faced. And David's oldest brother was irritated to see him and hear his questions about the battle. We talked about how when he saw everyone hiding in fear, this young shepherd boy made a bold statement that charged the atmosphere with faith in God. And we're going to read that today in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 29 in the King James Version of the Bible. It says, "And David said, 'What have I now done? Is there not a cause?'" That is so powerful. Think about that for a moment. You know, when he said that, everyone was amazed by the boldness and fearlessness of that teenager that day. His words became a rallying cry that were remembered and repeated. That's what we talked about in our last lesson. But now it's time for us to move on to the first point of this month's study. We should leave nothing undone that may glorify God. Think about that for a moment. Is there something that needs to be done that needs to glorify God in your life? And remember this, there is always a cause to stand up for. We're going to turn to the New Testament in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 now and continue our study. You know, in the battle of life, we always have to contend with numerous adversaries. David has his Goliath. You have some adversaries, I'm sure, in your life. You may have had a big sickness, a giant financial hurdle, or maybe some major family problem. What should you do about it? You know, the Bible has answers for things like this. That's why we're studying it. I want you to always remember that you have the sword of the Spirit in your mouth and in your hand. And this vital part of your armor enables you to stand against the wiles of the devil. And that's what we're about to read in Ephesians chapter 6, beginning in verse 10. Let's look together in the King James Bible. It says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God." I love that. You know, all the parts of the armor are defensive except the sword of the Spirit, and that is the Word of God. It's an active weapon that is to be used offensively. And the armor of God prepares us to withstand every attack of the enemy. So powerful to learn that and realize that God has given you this. But you know, you have to put it on. He won't put it on for you. You ever tried to dress a little kid that doesn't want to get dressed? You know, they have to cooperate. Well, we need to cooperate with God, and we have to, he has given it to us, but we have to put it on and believe what his word says. Now let's turn in our Bible back to 1 Samuel chapter 17, but we're going to read verse 45 through 47. You know, the battle is the Lord's, which is our theme for this month, but the fight is yours. And you have to take ownership of that. Realize that you have a part to play in this battle. God wants to give you the victory. You can have the victory, but we have to fight as well. And we fight with the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. And that day, if you remember, we talked in the study, David refused to hide in fear like his brothers and the entire army of Israel that day. He ran toward Goliath, declaring his great expectation that would get great results. Let's read this together in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 45 through 47 in the King James Version of the Bible. Then said David to the Philistine, "Thou comest to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee into mine hand, and I will smite thee and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air, unto the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. And all this assembly shall know that the Lord saveth not with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands." What a powerful, powerful declaration. What a powerful passage of Scripture. You know, every time something big comes against us, we must ask ourselves, how can we give glory to God in this situation? And our answer is always, win it. You see, we don't aim to lose in the Spirit. We aim to overcome and conquer whatever problem comes to us with the Word of God. And it's called great expectation, working to bring us great results. And it's important that you declare and say what you expect, just like David did when he ran toward that giant. Now let's look in our scriptures again at 1 Samuel chapter 17. We're going to look at verse 34 through 37. You know, if you read the story of David and Goliath, you'll find David giving glory to God for previous battles. And this is a key to his success as a young man. Let's look at that scripture in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 34 through 37. It says, "And David said unto Saul, Thy servant kept his father's sheep, and there came a lion and a bear, and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he rose against me, I caught him by his beard and smote him and slew him. Thy servant slew both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing he hath defied the armies of the living God." David said, "Moreover, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine." And Saul said unto David, "Go, and the Lord be with thee." Think about that. He reminded everyone about what God had already done in his life, how he put things, and he brought glory to God by his past victories. And David's thought process that day was to remember the victories and remind others about them too. We need to do this. Do you remember the times in the past where you defeated your enemy? Think about that for a moment. When you applied the Word of God and you got victory, well, that same principle that worked you in your life to bring about those past victories will bring about your future one. Those memories will help you increase in strength and boldness for the day's battle. Why? Because when you remind yourself and give glory to God for those wins in your life, you are telling your brain to stop fearing. You're telling yourself you won before and you will win again. The Word of God is powerful, but it is most powerful in your life when it's coming out of your heart and out of your mouth. And that's in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. You can look it up later on your own. You know, as believers, we'll have to confront difficulties. But like David, we must call upon holy courage in the battles of life. I believe that God is using this teaching today to help you to call upon holy courage to remember the good things that he's already done in your life. And maybe, you know, if you're brand new and you don't have any good things to remember, the Word of God is filled with good things that God has already done for those that believed him. And that's what's also available to you. God wants you to have great victory in your life. We've already come to the end of the study, and we like to close with our confessions. We have to confess what we expect. And we have two of them today. Let's say these together. And again, they're based on what we just learned in our brief study. Number one, I leave nothing undone that may glorify God, and always remember that I have the sword of the Spirit in my mouth and in my hand. The battle is the Lord's, but the fight is mine. Number two, I overcome and conquer whatever problem comes to me with the Word of God. I call upon holy courage in the battles of life and declare, I won before and I will win again. Praise the Lord. You know, you've won before, you're going to win again. Remember that. God has a great victory for you ahead. And that's why you're studying with me today, because God wants you to be victorious every single day. Let's close in prayer. Father, I thank you for your word, that you're breeding courage within us. You're strengthening us for the days ahead, for the battle, Lord, so that we can be victorious every single day. Lord, I pray for every person watching as they've read. Lord, teach them by your Spirit that they are more than conquerors in this life, and they can overcome any attack and any battle and rise victorious. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all things Jesse Duplantis Ministries. God bless.
This media is copyrighted by Jesse Duplantis Ministries for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this media or of any pictures or accounts without Jesse Duplantis Ministries' consent is strictly prohibited.